Let me ask you this. Do you guys ever struggle at winning fights in Fortnite? You know, maybe it's when you're in a final two situation and you can't quite secure the win. Or maybe every time that you get into the mid game, you just get W-keyed by just like a psycho and you can't quite consistently beat them. Push Across Tommy, where you at your motivation guy. That's right, I am back. And I'm so excited today because today's video, we're gonna be going over some of the main reasons why you keep losing fights and what you can do to consistently win your fights in early game and mid game and even in the final two situation. Are you guys ready for this? I know I am. Let's get this going. All right, guys, let's be real. Fortnite has a lot of RNG. I mean, that's part of what makes the game so fun to play, right? I mean, you never know what's going to happen next. But when it comes to fighting other players, this RNG can become rather frustrating, as it can really just easily become like the difference between life or death. You know, knowing how to deal with this RNG and how to exploit the RNG to make the odds go in your favor can really help, honestly, make any fight go in your direction and allow you to consistently defeat your opponents. Who wants to do that? I know I do. RNG comes into play in Fortnite fighting in a few different ways, from positioning in the fight to your loadout and the weapons that you have, to whose shots hit harder when diving into boxes. But through a few simple methods, guys, you can really make the RNG go in your favor. All right, so let me tell you this, man. First off, when dealing with RNG, make sure it's actually RNG. Like, here's what I mean by that. You know, a lot of times players' first instinct is to blame their unfortunate circumstances on RNG, which a lot of times may be correct, but sometimes RNG may not be the blame, and sometimes RNG can be manipulated to, you know, a point where it doesn't even exist anymore. In fact, like, to be real, like, most times blaming your situation on RNG and never really thinking about it can be a very destructive habit. All right, let me give you this example, all right? Like, say you're rotating out of Lazy Lake towards zone and you're running towards the north of the edge of the river, and someone begins to beam you from the high ground on the mountain. And so while you're healing up, the opponent who just beams you just pushes you, while another player hears the shots and just begins to push and just spray from the back, causing you to die just a bit later. All right, so is that RNG? You know, while it may seem like totally random, and in some ways it is, you know, doing a few different things like can really take the randomness out of that fight and really help you win. And so when leaving any location in Fortnite, guys, consider the landscape around you and where potentially people should be stationed on your rotation path, and just try to plan accordingly. You know, think of every possible avenue and the best way to rotate in without putting yourself in a compromising position. So instead of just rotating in through the low valley and exposing yourself to multiple mountains, try and rotate up the mountain out of Lazy, and doing so, like, you know, would have allowed you to really survey the entire map and even get the jump on the opponent camping up there, giving you guys the upper hand. So, you know, always put yourself in the best position possible in case you do get into a fight, to really ensure you always have the upper hand position-wise, all right? When it comes to dealing with the RNG of loadouts, all right, and dealing with the fact that sometimes the enemy player may have better guns than you, there are really two main ways to really combat that. All right, number one, make sure that you are maximizing the amount of loot that you're getting as possible. This is often an underlooked aspect in Fortnite, but oftentimes a single chest can be the difference between having an average loadout and a legendary tier loadout. So make sure that you're always hitting as many chests and loot spots as possible to maximize the possibility, you know, to get as much good loot as possible, right? You know, using Fortnite.gg's map tool to view all chests and loot spots can be used to effectively plan your loot route and, you know, any drops out, and really just get the most out of it to really ensure you have the best loot when arriving in your fights. But even if you're not able to find any good loot, guys, like, hope shouldn't be lost. And that brings us to the second way to combat enemies with a better loadout. Number two, even if the opponent you're like fighting has insane loot, having the best aim in the fight will instantly make your guns more effective and deal more damage than his if you hit your shots, even if his guns are legendary and your guns are just only rare. Having that upper hand and aim will basically cause your guns to do more damage effectively than his. I mean, this really shows the importance of having exceptional aim to win more fights. So doing third-party aim routines such as like Kovacs or Aim Labs, or, you know, doing an in-game creative aim routine inside of Fortnite will greatly help you guys improve your aiming ability. All right, let me ask you this. Like, I'm not sure where to start. Pro Guys has a wide array of like Fortnite coaches skilled in aim training available 24/7. These coaches can often get you on the right track by teaching you how to start and giving you guys a routine that you could do on your own time. It is crazy. These methods are proven to guarantee better aim in the player, which will in turn allow you to win more fights, even against players with better loot than you. And all you need to do, man, to get started is click the link in the top right. All right, guys, so bunch of crunch zombie, we talked about how you should do everything in your power to make the odds go in your favor before a fight, but that also applies during a fight as well. You know, Fortnite fights often end up in a box fight, with both players ending up in the same box before one of them dies. These are usually referred to as 50-50s. All right, there is a 50% chance that each player is gonna win. And so while hopping in someone's box is a good strategy, you know, taking 50-50s is not. Why would you want to put your entire game in a 50-50 gamble where you might win or you might lose at all? And so you're gonna always need to take risks, right? But leaving your whole game up to a 50-50 chance is not very strategic. Instead of just taking a 50-50, guys, like, try and make it a 90-10, where you have a 90% chance to win your fight. You know, employing strategies to combat RNG like positioning, loot paths, and aim are all great places to really start. But while in a fight mid-game, don't ever take a 50-50. Instead, just stay out of the opponent's way and just consistently try to spray the enemy and just wear them down to a level where you can hop in their box and confidently win the fight. This can be done by spraying them, by pressuring them, and much more. You know, positioning yourself a layer above your enemy while they are boxed and consistently pressuring their walls and staying out of their box while taking walls and using edits, like the peanut butter peek, to slowly lower the enemy's health is a fantastic way to turn the 50-50 into a 90-10 before hopping into the box. All right, so as soon as you get into a position where you feel confident you can win the fight after wearing down your opponent's health, materials, and morale, and then it's just really time to hop in and just finish the job, man. You know, using the classic box fight technique to really take their wall and then use whatever technique you prefer to trap them in their box, whether it be through, you know, placing a cone in their box or a Mongrel classic, trap the player and then hop in and finish the job, securing your dominance over your opponent, man. That is the best way to play this game. All right, so far we've discussed many good techniques and strategies that will really help you win more fights, but perhaps the biggest piece of advice that I can give you, your motivation guy, is what I like to call the 3 P's. Can anybody guess what the 3 P's are? I feel like I'm in school right now. This is Fortnite school. I like this. They stand for practice. Oh yeah, that word again. Practice. You know, just like anything you do in life, man, practice will make you better, but consistent practice will make you the best. And who wants to be the best? If you want to be the best, you gotta love this word called practice. You know, consistently practicing fights and just doing so for a purpose is going to be a huge thing that you need to do if you want to start winning more fights. Whether it's in the arena or through playing creative box fights or realistics, in any way that you can practice those fighting skills repeatedly will help you perfect the art of winning fights. While practice is essential, you're gonna still wanna make sure that you're not aimlessly practicing. You know, while practicing these fights, make sure to not zone out and to stay focused and just remember the techniques that you've learned and apply those techniques while practicing. And so along the way, like, take note of what goes wrong and what exactly is causing you to be eliminated and just try to think of strategic ways to correct those mistakes. And so if you're still unable to fix why you're dying, right, and being eliminated game after game, you know, try talking to a friend and just see if they have any fresh ideas. You know, Pro Guys coaches are also a great resource to really help with this solution. And so if you're a pro member at Pro Guys, you can message Pro Guys coaches 24/7 for free. So if you're not a pro member, consider just booking any coach for a short session and they'll gladly help you guys. So remember, I love you guys. Remember this though, man. Practice. Those are the 3 P's. All right, guys, so those were what we think are the biggest reasons that you're currently losing fights in Fortnite. And as long as you start to really twist the odds in your favor and, you know, follow things like what we talked about, the 3 P's, you're gonna start to see the rate that you win fights dramatically increase. You know, sure, it may take a little bit of a time, but, you know, eventually you're gonna be fighting on the next level, man, of some of the best of the best. You can do it. I am your number one fan, and remember that. Hey, if you guys liked the video, make sure you sub to the channel and connect with me on my Instagram at Your Motivation Guy. Keep grinding, don't stop, never quit. I'll see you on the next one. Peace.